What's up, guys? Pro Strat number 17, where pros do strats. And we've been seeing a little more CT Inferno pistol pushes, great phrasing by me, where you'll send four people down mid, or at least three. One person banana is going to look for picks down here, down the banana angle here from car. And you're going to be basically looking for early picks, surprising your opponents around either this bottom mid area here, or in this alt mid area here, to give yourself an early advantage and either capitalize on the early picks or to basically reset the round and work from there. So in theory, because T's don't want to fight you mid early, you have that free real estate to take that area, this area of mid here, and catch them off guard by looking for picks, looking for kills, and basically giving yourself an early advantage. Now, I'm going to be going through two demos. This is the first demo, Wendigo versus Navi. And the second demo is going to be from ESL New York, Astralis versus EG. And this round in particular is going to be probably the most classic way this round can happen. So like I mentioned before, we're going to have four people going towards mid. You're actually going to have three people pushed down with one person spotting T-ramp from the top of mid. And you'll be having one banana. Now let's look at the early setup again. Here you can see through X-ray that you have three people going down mid. It's actually going to be Mirabit, Bubble, and Haji, who's over here and invisible for some reason. We're going to have Poison over here. He's going to be spotting the T-ramp from this top mid area. And then we have Kalyx, who is on B solo. He's going to be playing very safe this round, but this is going to be your initial setup. Three down mid, one's going to be spotting top mid, two T-ramp. And you're basically going to start looking for picks around this mid area. So here, they're going to start swinging, and Bubble is going to notice this one player. Well, more so his team. He's going to notice the one player at T-ramp, and at the exact same time, Mirabit, who's over here, is going to spot Flamey and Boomich going towards apartments. Now, fortunately, Flamey had the bomb, and it's going to get dropped right there. So now they see that bomb is alt. They see there's at least one more person in alt mid going towards apartments, and they only saw the one person at T-ramp, while also they don't see anyone banana. Bubble's actually going to push and be in charge of making sure that no one else is banana or T-ramp so that they can focus all their attention towards alt. They can already suspect that there's going to be a lot of people towards alt considering bomb was there, so this is more of a double check than it is anything else. So here you're going to see Bubble. He peek down T-ramp, and since he sees nothing, there's probably no one else to contest him at this bottom T-ramp area, which further confirms the fact that this is an alt play. And here we just have an aggressive play from Poison, who actually managed to get a kill on Boomich, who was trying to push the apartments right here. All the while, you have three people now fighting alt mid because Kalyx, he's going to start aggressing towards banana to T-ramp. Since it was only with the one person there, that one person's not going to be looking for fights by himself, knowing there's three people here. And you're going to see a lot of fighting towards alt mid. So this is exactly what Wendigo wants. They want these early picks, and they want to mess up Navi from setting up what they want to do. Navi's reaction to what happened here is actually really smart. They reset the round too. They want to reset the situation and make it a 2B3A setup. You can't know for sure that banana is going to be clear because you've had no information ever since maybe a minute 30 into the round. But what they are doing here is waiting out for rotations. They want them to reset and not hold these close angles so that they can execute and make the defense not stacked, essentially. This could very well be a 4A setup and one spotting banana. But thankfully for Navi, Wendigo is actually playing a 2B setup, albeit a very aggressive 2B setup. So now we're going to look at Evil Geniuses versus Astralis from ESL 1 New York 2019. And this is exactly the same pistol round. CTs are going to be pushing down mid. You're going to have one towards B. Here we're going to see their setup, which is going to be three people towards mid, interestingly enough, without the bomb. And then two people towards alt mid, just holding for a default, holding a very passive and, well, defaulty setup, because they're waiting for this aggression since it's been done against them so many times. So we're going to watch this round play out a little bit. And you're going to see how prepared Astralis are for this push. You have Dupree going from alt mid straight into Mexi to catch someone off guard that's pushing down mid. All the while, you're going to have two people pushed up into really good positions inside Banana to not get crunched from Taric, who's going to be in car, and from Ethan, who made it already to bottom mid against the wall. Ethan won't actually be able to fight the two Banana players of Astralis unless they push past Glaive, which is not necessarily a fight you want to take, considering you don't know how many people are going to be there since they saw nobody alt mid. Zipnix doesn't necessarily know this is going to be a mid push quite yet, but right around now, he's going to realize that, oh, this is a mid push, and he immediately hides in this corner right here. And this is insanely smart by Zipnix, because he knows in this kind of setup, there's going to be one player who wants to peek from window and from balcony to clear alt mid. And once this is clear, you can actually just shoot below people or from people below you. And anyone that's alt mid trying to fight down alt mid is going to be really in a weird spot, because they have to fight this balc player and the player alt mid, and it's just super awkward. Zipnix knows this is coming and almost gets the timing. So right around here, he's going to start falling back to help his team. But the timing is just barely off, so that Cirq can narrowly see his head as he's just about to leave the window room, and actually manages to gush Zipnix to 31 before Zip actually gets away. Now, Astralis knows what's happening. EG kind of have an idea of what's happening. And we're going to actually see a really good counterplay by Glaive here. He's going to double flash bottom mid from the back of T-Ramp by the moped, and they're going to start looking for fights here. Now, all the while, Taric has actually pushed Banana, and he's beginning to peek, and from here, this is just good fighting. Good shots by Taric. He does get the player in logs, which was Magisk, and now Device is still here. This is going to be a fight, obviously, and Taric just needs to stall. Now remember that those two flashes went off right about here, and Dupree is trying to come out of Mexi to start taking the fights, hoping that the CTs are blind, but Stan is, well, not blind, and manages to get the kill. So let's watch a little more of this round, as Taric should be getting this other kill right about now. Nope, Stan's going to get it. And now we are in a 4v2. Banana has been pinched and cleared. The T-Ramp players are forced to fall back because they can't contest this lane right here since there's like three people here. So their only real option at the moment is alt, but the problem is the CTs, once they realize this, can very easily beat them to alt and contest them down this lane here. Now if Cirq had not pushed mid, there could very easily be a CT in, let's say, pit, on site, in boiler watching this lane right here, or this angle right here. Astralis played this basically perfectly from a strategic and theoretical standpoint. They read the situation perfectly. They had the counter utility and the proper, well, counter to the strategy. But Stan getting the kill on the Mexi player, along with Glaive not being able to get one off of his flashes, make this round basically over. That was their only real chance of winning the round. So anyway, thanks for watching, and like the video if you like the video.